नमस्ते एंड वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ ऑनलाइन मैथमेटिक्स क्लास। लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द टॉपिक पाइथागोरस थ्योरम एंड द कन्वर्स ऑफ पाइथागोरस थ्योरम एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सम प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 6.5 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी क्लास 10 मैथमेटिक्स टेस्ट। टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 6.5। लेट मी स्टार्ट। एबीसी इज एन आइसोसेलस ट्रायंगल राइट एंगल्ड एट सी। प्रूव दैट AB square is equal to 2AC square. So here we can draw an isosceles right angled triangle at C. So we can mark ABC. Since it is an isosceles triangle, BC equal to AC. Okay, hypotenuse is the longest side. So we can conclude BC and AC are equal. Given ABC is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, BC equal to AC. Since it is a right triangle, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. So, by Pythagoras theorem, we get the hypotenuse AB square is equal to base square plus altitude square, that is BC square plus AC square. Okay, what we have to prove? AB square is equal to 2AC square. So we can convert AC in terms of BC. Here BC and AC are equal, both are equal. So BC can be replaced by AC. AC square plus AC square, which gives 2AC square. Hence the proof. AB square is equal to 2AC square. Okay. Now the next question is, ABC is an isosceles triangle with AC equal to BC. If AB square is equal to 2AC square, comma, prove that ABC is a right triangle. Okay. So we can draw a triangle ABC. Here it is given that it is an isosceles triangle with AC equal to BC. So these two sides are equal. So given ABC is an isosceles triangle with AC equal to BC. Also given AB square is equal to 2AC square. Also given AB square is equal to 2AC square. So here we can split this term. 2AC square can be written as AC square plus AC square. Here AC equal to BC. So one AC we can replace by BC. BC square plus AC square. Now we get AB square is equal to BC square plus AC square. So here we got the square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. So by converse of Pythagoras theorem, the angle which is opposite to the first side is a right angle. So here angle C will be a right angle. So what we can conclude, it is a right triangle. Okay. Therefore, by converse of Pythagoras theorem, we get triangle ABC is a right triangle. Okay. Now we move on to question number 6. ABC is an equilateral triangle of side 2A. So we can draw an equilateral triangle of side 2A. ABC 2A 2A. Here also 2a. Find each of its altitudes. So here we can draw one altitude from the vertex A. So here we can mark it as D. So AD is the altitude from the vertex A. Clearly the altitude AD divides BC into two equal parts. BD and DC are equal. So BD measure we can mark it as A, here also A. total length 2a, 32 divides it into two parts, so a and a. Now from this right triangle we can find the altitude ad. Okay, so in right triangle ADC, AD square plus DC square, AD square plus DC square is equal to AC square. AD square plus DC, DC is A, A square equal to AC. The length of AC is 2A, 2A the whole square. That is AD square equal to 2A the whole square is 4A square, then minus A square. So AD square is equal to 3a square and ad equal to root of 3a square, that will be equal to root 3a. Therefore what we can conclude, therefore altitude is of length root 3a, altitude is equal to root 3a. Okay, now we shall discuss question number 16. In an equilateral triangle, prove that 3 times the square of one side is equal to 4 times the square of one of its altitudes. So it is the continuation of question number 6. So in order to prove this one, first we have to prove question number 6. This much portion we have to write first, and in addition to that we have to do some more steps. Okay, so first of all we have to write this much step. Then after that we can write here 3 times the square of one of its side. So 3 into side square, which is equal to 3 into, here we take the side as 2a, so 2a the whole square. That is 3 into 4a square, which is equal to 12a square. We can take it as equation number 1. 4 times the square of one of its altitude. So 4 into altitude square, which is equal to 4 into the length of altitude, we got it as root 3a. So here we can replace the value root 3a the whole square, and which is equal to 4 into 3a square, that is 12a square, equation 2. So from 1 and 2 we can conclude 3 times the square of one side is equal to 4 times the square of one of its altitudes. Okay, 3 into side square is equal to 4 into altitude square. Understood? Now we move on to question number 7. Prove that the sum of the squares of the sides of a rhombus is equal to the sum of the squares of its diagonals. So first of all we can draw a rhombus. Name it as ABCD and we can mark the diagonals AC and B. Intersect at O. Okay, we know that the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles. That means OA equal to OC and OB equal to OD. Then here the angles are equal to 90 degree. Okay, so first we can write, since the diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles, we get OA equal to OC and OB equal to OD. And angle AOB equal to angle BOC equal to angle COD equal to angle AOD equal to 90 degree. Okay, AOB, BOC, COD and AOD. Now we get four right triangles. So in each of the triangles, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. First, you take the triangle AOB. So in right triangle AOB, by Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square, that is AB square, is equal to OA square plus OB square. We can take it as equation one. And in the second triangle DOC, hypotenuse is BC. So BC square is equal to OB square plus OC square. Equation 2. Then take the next triangle COD. In right triangle COD, here the hypotenuse is DC or CD. So CD square is equal to OC square plus OD square. Equation 3. Now we can take the next triangle AOD or DOA. So in triangle AOD, here the hypotenuse is AD. So AD square equal to OD square plus OA square. Take it as equation number 4. Now what we have to prove? Sum of the squares of the sides of a rhombus. Here in the LHS part, we got the square of the sides, square of four sides, AB square, BC square, CD square and AD square. Sum of the squares. So we have to take the sum. That means we have to add these four equations. And what we have to get, which is equal to the sum of the squares of its diagonals. That we have to prove. Okay. So first of all, we can add these four equations. Equation 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 implies LHS part AB square plus BC square plus CD square plus AD square, which is equal to, here we can replace the values, OA square plus OB square plus OB square plus OC square, then plus OC square plus OD square, then plus OD square plus OA square. OA square, OA square, that is 2 OA square. Similarly, OB square plus OB square, 2 OB square. Then OC square plus OC square, 2 OC square. And OD square plus OD square, 2 OD square. And we can apply the result, OA equal to OC and OB equal to OD. So this OC can be written as OA and OD can be written as OB. So 2 OA square plus 2 OB square plus, again 2 OA square plus, since OC equal to OA, 2 OB square, because OD is equal to OB. Okay. So which is equal to 2 OA square plus 2 OA square, that is 4 OA square, then plus 2 OB square plus 2 OB square, that is 4 OB square. And this can be rewritten as 2 OA the whole square. Here 2 OB the whole square. And look at the figure. What is 2 OA? OA equal to OC. So when we take the double of OA, we will get the diagonal AC. So AC square plus 2 OB square. So OB, OD, both are equal. And when we take the double of OB, we will get the diagonal BD. So this can be written as BD square. Hence the proof. Here the LHS part is what? AB square plus BC square plus CD square plus AD square. And that will be equal to the sum of the squares of its diagonals, AC square plus BD square. Okay. Here the next question is, in figure O is a point in the integer of a triangle ABC. OD perpendicular to BC. Here OD is perpendicular to the side BC. OE perpendicular to AC. And OF perpendicular to AB. Show that there are two sub-questions. OA square plus OB square plus OC square minus OD square minus OE square minus OF square. That will be equal to AF square plus BD square plus CE square. And the second one is AF square plus BD square plus CE square equal to AE square plus CD square plus BF square. Okay. First of all, we can make some constructions. Here we can join AO, then BO and CO. Okay. And we can take the triangle AOF first. In triangle AOF, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. OA is the hypotenuse. So OA square is equal to AF square plus OF square. Okay, take it as equation 1. Then we can take the triangle OBD. In triangle OBD, where the hypotenuse is OB, so OB square is equal to OD square plus BD square. Equation 2. Then take the triangle OCE. So in triangle OCE, and the hypotenuse is OC. So OC square is equal to OE square plus CE square. Equation 3. Now we can add these three equations. Equation 1 plus 2 plus 3 implies OA square plus OB square plus OC square equal to AF square plus OF square, then plus OD square plus BD square, then plus OE square plus CE square. Now we can rearrange the terms. Here in the proof, we have to get OA square plus OB square plus OC square, then minus OD square, minus OE square, and minus OF square. Here we got all the terms. We can rearrange the terms. That is OA square plus OB square plus OC square minus OD square minus OE square minus OF square. That will be equal to, and on the orth spot, AF square, BD square, CE square. AF square, BD square, and CE square. So AF square plus BD square plus CE square. Okay, the first part is all. Then the second part, here AF square plus BD square plus CE square equal to AE square plus CD square plus BF square. We have already proved in one, AF square plus BD square plus CE square is this much thing. Okay, that we can write first. We have AF square plus BD square plus CE square equal to OA square plus OB square plus OC square minus OD square minus OE square minus OF square. Proved in first part. Now we can rearrange the terms. We have to get AE square, CD square, BF square. AE square, look at the figure. AE square, AE, okay, AE square equal to OA square minus OE square in this triangle. Okay, OA is the hypotenuse, so OA square minus OE square. So you can rearrange the terms. OA square minus, here on OE square, that we can write first, then plus, what is the next term? CD square. CD is the side of this triangle ODC. CD square, OC square minus OD square. Here it is OC square, OD square. Okay. So OC square minus OD square. Then plus, the next term is BF square. So BF is the side of this triangle BOF. So OB hypotenuse, OB square minus OF square. Here OB square, OF square. Okay. So OB square minus OF square, and this will be equal to OA square minus OE square, that is AE square. So AE square plus and OC square minus OD square is CD square, then plus OB square minus OF square is what? BF square. And hence the proof. Clear? Now we move on to question number 13. D and E are points on the sides CA and CB respectively of a triangle ABC right angle at C. Prove that AE square plus BD square is equal to AB square plus DE square. So draw a triangle ABC which is right angled at C. ABC. D and E are points on the sides CA and CB. So here we can mark D, here E. Okay. Prove that AE square plus BD square. So first of all we can join AE then BD. It is equal to AB square plus DE square. For that we have to join DE also. First we can take the triangle ABC. In right triangle ABC, AB square equal to BC square plus AC square. Okay, we can take it as equation 1. And take this small triangle DEC. It's also right angle triangle. So in triangle DEC, DE is the hypotenuse. So DE square equal to EC square plus DC square. Take it as equation 2. Now in triangle AEC, in right triangle AEC, AE is the hypotenuse. So AE square equal to EC square plus AC square. EC square plus AC square. Equation 3. Now there is one more right triangle. DBC. DBC. So in triangle DBC, here BD is the hypotenuse. BD square equal to BC square plus DC square. You can take it as equation number 4. We want to prove AE square plus BD square equal to AB square plus DE square. So we can add equation 3 and 4 first. Equation 3 plus 4 implies AE square plus BD square equal to EC square plus AC square plus BC square plus DC square. Now we can rearrange the terms. We want to prove AB square plus DE square. So AB square is BC square plus AC square. So that we can write first BC square plus AC square. Then plus next DE square. DE square is EC square plus DC square. So EC square plus DC square. We can replace the values. That is AB square plus DE square using equations 1 and 2. Okay, here the next question is, the perpendicular from A on side BC of a triangle ABC intersect BC at D such that DB equal to 3CD. This length DB will be equal to 3 times CD. That means if BC is divided into 4 equal parts, then one of the part is what? CD. Or we can say CD is the 1 by 4th of the total length BC. Okay. We have to prove 2AB square equal to 2AC square plus BC square. So given DB equal to 3CD, therefore CD equal to 1 by 4 of BC. From the picture, it is very clear. Okay. If BC is divided into 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 equal parts, then we can say CD is the 1 by 4th of the total length BC, since the relation is DB is 3 times CD. Okay, here in DB there will be 3 CDs. Okay, So total 4 CD equal to BC. So CD equal to 1 by 4 of BC. Okay. Now we can take the triangle ACD. So in triangle ACD, what we can write? AC square equal to AD square plus CD square. We can take it as equation number 1. Now take the second triangle ADB. In triangle ADB, AB square equal to what? AD square plus DB square. That is AD square plus, this DB can be written as the total length BC minus CD. So BC minus CD whole square. Now we can expand this one. AD square plus A minus B the whole square. So BC square minus 2BC into CD, then plus CD square. First we can rearrange the term, first term and last term we can take together. AD square plus CD square, then plus BC square minus 2BC into, this CD can be written as 1 by 4 BC. So 1 by 4 BC. Here this 2 and 4 we can cancel, we get 2. And what is AD square plus CD square? By using one we can write AD square plus CD square as what? AC square. So AC square plus BC square minus half BC square. Or we can write AC square plus 1 minus half. 1 minus half is half. Half BC square. Okay. BC square minus 1 by 2 BC square will be equal to how much? 1 by 2 BC square. So left side is AB square. AB square equal to AC square plus 1 by 2 BC square. Now we can multiply the whole equation by 2. So 2AB square equal to here 2AC square, then plus here 2 cancel, we get BC square. That's the proof. 2AB square equal to 2AC square plus BC square. Okay. Now we move on to question number 15. In an equilateral triangle ABC, D is a point on side BC such that BD equal to 1 by 3 BC. So here ABC is an equilateral triangle. D is a point on side BC such that BD equal to 1 by 3 BC. So first of all we can divide the base BC into 3 equal parts. And on the first point we can mark D. Okay. Now BD equal to 1 by 3 BC. Clear? Now we can join this one. Prove that 9 AD square equal to 7 AB square. So first we can write, given ABC is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. So all sides are equal. AB equal to BC equal to AC. Also given BD equal to 1 by 3 BC. Now in order to prove this one, we have to draw a perpendicular from the vertex A to the base BC. Here I mark it as P. Okay, so here we can write, draw AP perpendicular to BC. Since it is an equilateral triangle, the altitude AP bisect BC. So BP equal to PC, or we can say BP is the half of BC. Then we can write here. So BP equal to half BC. Now one more value we have to find out, DP. So here DP can be written as BP minus BD. BP minus BD. BP is half BC and BD is 1 by 3 BC. Here we can cross multiply 3 minus 2, 1 by 6. That is 1 by 6 BC. So DP is 1 by 6 BC. Okay. Now in triangle APD, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. In triangle APD, AD square equal to AP square plus DP square. We can change this one. From this we can write AP square equal to AD square minus DP square. Take it as equation number 1. Clear? Now we can take the right triangle APB. APB. Okay. So in triangle APB, here the hypotenuse is AB. So AB square equal to AP square plus BP square. Instead of AP square, we can put the value AD square minus DP square. So AD square minus DP square, then plus BP square using equation 1. And which is equal to AD square. AD square we write as it is AD square. Then DP. DP equal to what? 1 by 6 BC. We can replace the value 1 by 6 BC the whole square. Then plus BP. BP is 1 by 2 BC. So here 1 by 2 BC the whole square. That is AD square minus 1 by 36 BC square. Here 1 by 4 BC square. Here it is AB square. And in the proof, the only terms are AD and AB. And being it is an equilateral triangle, AB equal to BC equal to AC. So BC can be replaced by AB. Okay. So AB square equal to AD square minus 1 by 36 AB square, then plus 1 by 4 AB square. Now we can multiply the whole equation by 36. So multiplying by 36, we get 36 AB square, which is equal to 36 AD square, then minus. Here 36 cancel, AD square, then plus 36 into 1 by 4, 9 AB square. So 36 AD square, which is equal to 36 AD square, minus 1 AB square plus 9 AB square, plus 8 AB square. This term we can take it to the left side, 36 AD square minus 8 AB square equal to 36 AD square. 36 minus 8. 36 minus 8 is 28. 28 AB square equal to 36 AD square. Here we can cancel it by 4. 7 fours are 28. 9 fours are 36. Okay. 7 AB square equal to 9 AD square, or we can write that is 9 AD square equal to 7 AB square. Hence the proof. Understood? So this finishes exercise 6.5 as well as the chapter triangles. Thanks for watching. Thank you.